Teachers are back at work today after a 24-hour strike, but amid fears of further industrial action, experts say they're struggling to recruit on current pay rates in an ageing workforce. Emily Cooper has more.
Warnings of more strikes, with teachers refusing to back down over pay talks.
Until we get enough teachers in front of kids, we've got a crisis.
Further action could even include a week-long strike by region.
Mr Speaker, the government's committed to going back to the negotiating table with teachers and principals next week. We are listening to their concerns and are committed to good faith bargaining. Discussion of further strike action is premature.
Education Professor Peter O'Connor says something's got to give.
They have to move. If they don't move, teachers will continue to strike. I have no doubt about that.
The ministry is proposing to lift teacher salaries by around 6 to 14% over 3 years and principal salaries by 6 to 11% over 3 years. Internationally, Kiwi teaching wages are down. According to the OECD, starting salaries here average around $45,000. That's half the amount of Germany and Switzerland. There's also bigger starting salaries elsewhere in the civil service, such as new police recruits, who get $56,000. Concern too around the rising age of Kiwi teachers.
Half of the teaching force is going to retire within the next 8 years. We're really worried about where we're going to get the next generation of teachers from.
And added pressure of new issues in classrooms.
People talk a lot about pee babies, fetal alcohol. There's a lot of complexity there, and it does require resourcing. And teachers are getting more and more of it, but we're not getting more and more resources.
The last government pretended we didn't have a housing crisis. This government seems to be pretending that we don't have an education crisis. We have a genuine crisis. We do not have enough people coming into the profession. We have an ageing profession.
Last year, government put in $9.5 million to try and relieve immediate pressures, plus more in this year's budget. But the teachers' union says it's still not enough, ahead of negotiations next week. Emily Cooper, One News.